You're supposed to be doing this, not me.
Oh yeah, Walt's been sitting there doing nothing.
Why are you sitting here doing nothing?
Falling asleep with his little hula girls on his shirt.
What the hell? It won't go in. Oh, it's the wrong side.
You need Walt to help you?
No, I put it in the other side.
No, that's not that side.
It's not that side?
I don't think so. It's gonna take a while. Anyway, this album here is September Morn, Neil Diamond. And September Morn was a hit for him. I think that was the only one that only hit on it, but maybe not. I don't know. The Good Lord Loves You.
It won't slide on the other side of the thing that holds it together.
Mama Don't Know. That Kind, Jazz Time. He redid Dancing in the Streets on this album. Remember, you know, Martha and the Vandellas?
I don't even know what you're talking about.
Neil Diamond.
I was
September Morn.
Oh, September Morn.
Yeah. Dancing in the Streets, he redid that one. The Shelter of Your Arms, The Sun Ain't Gonna Shine Anymore. He redid Stagger Lee. Remember Stagger Lee? Redid that one. And he redid
Boy Price.
And he redid one of his own songs that the Monkees made a hit of. Because that was how he got started. Remember what song it was that he got started with?
No.
You don't remember? Come on. Get it out. What do the Monkees do that are Neil Diamond's?
They shit a lot.
Not those Monkees.
What the
Davy Jones?
Monkees?
And, yeah, no, Davy Jones, Mickey Dolenz.
Well, they do it that? They dance
Peter
a lot.
Tork.
Did you on the beach?
You remember one of their first hits, though?
I'm a Believer.
That was the one that Neil
yeah.
Diamond wrote.
Right.
Anyway, he redid it on this album. It's different than what the Monkees
yeah.
did, of course. But
yeah.
I don't know. Anyway, so there you go. I don't know if you want to hear any of those or not.
I know. I just about had it with Neil Diamond.
Yeah, me too.
Your Mama Don't Dance. Oh, that's the wrong song. That Kind, Jazz Time. They're dancing in the street. I don't know.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so that was Neil Diamond.
That was Neil Diamond.
Yeah, excitement's too much.
September Morn with all his hairs on his chest and his clean shaven.
Yep. And my ex-wife loved him.
You want me to hold it up there again so you can get a good picture of him?
Oh, sure.
There you go, ladies. All right, we're all
set. Oh, look, we got a poster in this one of the two.
One more time, you want to see Neil? There he is. We can keep him up there.
See, I didn't even know that was in there. There's a poster on the tubes. There were some strange looking guys. And they had
the
songs.
That's where the tubes came from.
Yeah.
That's their tube in front.
Yeah, and they got the songs listed there too, so. Huh. A big old picture tube.
Mm-hmm.
So. And then this one's got a lot of nice little picture there. And then, of course, he's got the records on that side. Got Peter
Well, you're trying to make it sound like it's worth something? Huh?
No.
Pictures, huh?
It's not worth nothing. I couldn't. Nobody wanted it. But, look at some of these albums it's got here. It's got, let's see, Frampton Comes Alive, how about The Captain and Tennille, The Carpenters, Rita Coolidge, Nazareth, Styx, here we go, Herb Albert.
You know what he's doing?
Peggy Lee. Joe Cocker.
He knows what he's doing.
Well, I'm just saying the different artists that were out during the same time this album came out. Which
if you want to reminisce like that, we get the book out and go through the book.
Well, I was waiting for that book,
but
I didn't see nothing. All right. Up from the Deep.
Uptight.
Space
it's
Baby.
Right.
Magnolia something or other. But the only one I White Punks on Dope. You know that one, don't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, but the
been there, done that.
the Mondo Bondage, which is what on the LP you see, the woman she's in
bondage.
Yeah. We can hang that one up too. What do you think?
What did you do? Go downstairs and rob my collection,
nope,
or what?
Nope, sure did.
Everything he's brought up so far, I got.
Well, you got pretty much everything anyway. Anyway, the one song
I'm trying to get rid of.
The one
song
I
have as much luck with it as you are.
Yeah, I know. But I'm giving you more. Giving you more shit, man.
My cellar's going to be full of shit.
Yeah.
Where's shit? Me don't see shit.
White Punks on Dope. I mean, that was not really a hit. It was a semi-hit for him. That was like, what, probably 102 or so?
Probably. I think it made 101 and a half.
But the one I had that was my favorite was What Do You Want From Life?
Never heard of it.
Number two. That's why it's time for you to
hear
it.
Time
for you to
hear
it.
Wait, the tubes. They talk to you later.
Yeah, but that none of that was on. These
are
the early stuff here.
And there was another one they did. She's a Beauty. Those two were great.
Attack of the 50-Foot Woman. All kinds of good stuff. I love the twos, but obviously nobody
Which
does.
Which one am I doing?
Number two. Okay. Obviously nobody does on eBay, because I couldn't sell this album for nothing.
Well, that's because all the people that were Tubes fans now are all going
dead.
Going to heaven on the
yeah.
water train.
Yeah, they're all dead. Yeah. I was a Tube fan. I'm still here, sort of. Yeah, I was there. Got it.
I'm trying to find the crack.
Yeah, look for the crack again.
It's right here.
There you go, you got it.
Ah! Now I got it.
What do you want from life? I want somebody that can just put the needle down. Shut up!
Okay.
What do you want from life? To kidnap an heiress? Or threaten her with a knife? What do you want from life? To get cable TV and watch it every night. There you sit a lump in your chair. Where do you sleep and what do you wear when you're sleeping? What do you want from life? An Indian clue to show you. Affair with a girl that you met tonight. How can you tell when you're doing all right? Does your bank account swell while you're dreaming at night? How do you know when you're really in love? Do violence play when you're touching the one that you love?
Citizen, you are entitled to a heated kidney-shaped pool, a microwave oven, don't watch the food cook, a Dynagym, I'll personally demonstrate it in the privacy of your own home, a king-size Titanic unsinkable Molly Brown waterbed with polybendum, a foolproof plan and an airtight alibi, real simulated Indian jewelry, a Gucci shoe tree, a year's supply of antibiotics, a personally autographed picture of Randy Mantooth and Bob Dylan's new unlisted phone number, a beautifully restored Third Reich swizzle stick, Rosemary's Baby! A dream date in knee pads with Paul Williams. A new Matador, a new Mastodon, a Maverick, a Mustang, a Montego, a Merc Montclair, a Mark IV, a Meteor, a Mercedes, an MG, or a Malibu, a Mort Moriarty, a Maserati, a Mack truck, a Mazda, a new Monza, or a moped, a Winnebago. Hell, I've heard of Winnebagos. We're giving them away. Or how about a McCullough chainsaw? A Las Vegas wedding, a Mexican divorce, a solid gold Kama Sutra coffee pot, or a baby's arm holding an apple.
Arm holding an apple. That was the last one. I see. There you go. It just shows the kind of stuff I like. That's what you want from life. Yeah, baby's arm holding an apple.